I call the Honourable Minister Tony Ryle.
Mr Speaker, what a great budget for New Zealand families. Up and down the country, people know that the John Key government is making children and families a priority in this budget and is absolutely determined to back those families. New Zealanders have got every reason to be optimistic about the future on the basis of this budget. Through very sound financial management by the Finance Minister, the Prime Minister and the rest of the Cabinet, this country is now in the black and is on a roll. This country is moving forward and we have options on how we can invest our finances now that our country is back in the black. And this budget stands in marked contrast to what you're seeing all around the world. Just look across to Australia, where the health budget's being cut by $10 billion. $10 billion. Australia, growth projections not as rosy as here. Things are much tougher over there. And governments having to make decisions that could not be made under the Labor Greens outfit that ran Australia up until a year ago. Look at Australia. Look at France, where the socialist Prime Minister, socialist President Hollande, is cutting $17 billion out of health expenditure. Socialist President, $17 billion out of health expenditure. That's part of $90 billion of cuts that have been announced in France by a socialist president. So all around the world, governments are still taking significant expenditure actions, but here in New Zealand, because of the sound financial management of our government, we're able to produce a budget which is in the black. And it's a budget for families, a budget for families, a budget for investing in the future of New Zealand. And it is marvellous to be serving as Health Minister in the John Key government, where we're putting $1.8 billion into health over 4 years. $1.8 billion made up of new money and savings in order to make sure that we can expand health services for New Zealanders and meet the cost pressures that we face. And let me just talk about what sound financial management in the health service can deliver. Because when I became Minister of Health, deficits in district health wards were expected to be $200 million. Well, we're now on track to get that down to $10 or $20 million because of sound financial management of our system. We're able to have $90 million going in to make GP visits and prescriptions free for children under the age of 13, 1st of July 2015. That's 400,000 children and their families are going to expect a benefit from this investment. It's an important preventive health measure, as parents won't have to think twice about taking their kids to their doctors, and it will relieve pressure on our busy hospital emergency departments. We're putting an extra $110 million into hips, knees and other elective surgeries to build on the record increase in elective surgery that we've had under this government. Remember, Mr Speaker, under the previous Labor government, they doubled the health budget and the number of people who got operations actually dropped. How does that work? You double the health budget and fewer people get operations. It just does not make sense. And we want more New Zealanders to get hips, knees and other elective procedures, and that's what this funding will be focused on. One of the things that's been overlooked in this budget so far is the government's very smart anti-obesity investment in Healthy Families New Zealand. $40 million over the next 4 years. It's a complete reform of the way that we address the underlying causes of poor health in New Zealand. Far too often, resources are spread too thinly in this public health area, and so what this Healthy Families New Zealand project, working across 900,000 of our population, will be building a dedicated health promotion workforce that will be engaging with early childhood centres, schools, sports clubs, eateries, caterers, helping them help their communities at a grassroots level to take responsibility and take action to improve the health and well-being of their communities. And we know it works. It's based on a program that's worked very successfully in Victoria, and it is going to make a big difference to many New Zealand families in many communities, such as South Auckland, West Auckland, and parts of the South Island as well. We're also putting in $33 million for faster cancer treatment. And what we're going to be doing here is addressing one of the major concerns we've picked up from cancer sufferers and their families around New Zealand. Being diagnosed with cancer is a time of extreme anxiety for anybody. A lot of concerns about what the future may hold. So this investment is going to allow us to put dedicated specialist psychologists into each of the six cancer centres around New Zealand to help support cancer sufferers and their families, but also dedicated counselling and social support staff, up to 20 of these support workers throughout the country, to ensure that patients who are diagnosed with cancer and their families receive more support and counselling. We've got more than 20,000 New Zealanders diagnosed with cancer every year, and this is a very important part about how we can support those families in their cancer journey, and I think that's a top spend by our government, including extra investment for breast and cervical cancer screening programs to ensure that more New Zealand women receive high quality screening services. And in fact, we now have digital mammography services throughout the whole of New Zealand. That's providing a much better quality of services for New Zealand women. And we're making a huge investment also in the training of our medical workforce. An extra 38 medical students will be able to go into our medical schools this year, and we're funding $18 million to provide more postgraduate training opportunities for the extra graduates that we're coming out of medical school. So we're growing more of our own doctors here in New Zealand. And it's a great investment that our government has made. We have got one major cut in health that Labor never criticises, and that's the cut of 1,000 managers and administrators. We've taken out 1,000 managers and administrators from the health service, and we've used that money to back the investment that we've made in well over 1,000 extra doctors and over 3,000 extra nurses at the bedsides of New Zealand patients in our hospitals. Over 1,000 extra doctors, over 3,000 extra nurses at the bedsides of our public hospitals. It's a huge investment that is allowing us to provide more elective surgery faster, better cancer treatment, and more elective surgery. 40,000 more operations, more hips, knees, and other elective operations. 40,000 in the last year compared to what we inherited under the previous government. I've got to say one thing about this budget that we've found is that Annette King and Russell Norman don't know how to read a budget. Because we've got the Greens going around the country saying that we're cutting the health budget over the next 3 years. It's completely wrong. What he hasn't taken into account is the fact that the numbers that he's looking at don't take into account the extra money that will come in next year's budget, and the next year's budget, and the next year's budget. So he's going around the country trying to tell people that we're reducing the health budget. We are increasing it year on year on year. When we started this job, it was much lower than where we were. Budget 2013, we are building on $1.56 billion of health investment this year. But it's not just about the money. It's got to be about the results for patients. And I make no apology for the fact that this government has put a lot of pressure on the public health service to deliver more. And we've delivered more care for patients. We don't send women to Australia for their breast cancer radiation treatment like that party did. Like that party did and made excuses for it. We're treating them all here in New Zealand faster than that crowd ever did. We're providing more hips, knees and other elective procedures than that party opposite ever did. So we're delivering the results that make a difference to make this the best country to be young and grow old.
Take it.
I call the Honourable Member Denise Roach. Tēnā koe, Miss Roach.
Tēnā koe.